In this video, we're looking at the CyberPower SX650U. It's a UPS. I purchased this back in January of 2019. It is December 2023, and the battery has failed on this. I've done some testing, and the battery can no longer hold a current. So I have two options. I can swap out this battery and gain full use of the UPS, or I can buy a new unit. And in this video, we're going to find out why I'm choosing to replace this unit. Your typical consumer UPS comes with at least one or two lead acid type batteries, like this one, and eventually they wear out. You're talking 3 to 5 years, at which point you have to make a decision. You either replace this and restore your unit. These are going for a minimum of about $20. Things to consider is, have you already populated this with a previous battery? So this is your third battery that you'd be putting into it, because the electronics in this do age, and so that's a factor to consider. And the other thing to consider is, what type of UPS is it that we are currently using? This one is a modified sine wave. So instead of a sine wave that just goes up and down, which electronics love, this has little stair steps in it going up and down. Not so good for sensitive electronics like stereos, television, computers, those kind of things. And that's exactly what this inverter does. So instead of investing $20 or $25 to replace this battery, I'm just going to invest in a UPS that it already has a sine wave output. Yes, it's going to cost me more money, but it's better for my electronics, and that's what I'm really trying to protect here. Of course, you could replace this battery and repurpose this device for stuff that isn't electronically sensitive. Fans, lamps, those type of things. So what am I replacing this with? Well, another CyberPower UPS. This one has full sine wave. It claims 145 minutes. Don't believe that. If you can just get 10 or 15, 20 minutes, depending on what you've plugged in, you should be happy, because that's all they're really meant for. It's just short durations of outage. If you plug a router into this, you're going to get probably an hour or so of running time. But just don't count on getting that number. It has 12 outlets. You can plug in USB and charge something with it. It provides surge protection of your devices and automatic voltage regulation. So if the power dips or goes up high, this unit will adjust it so that whatever devices you have plugged into it just see a steady state of 120. Let's open it up, take a look inside. By putting the unit on its side, we're able to lift the box up and out of the way. You have styrofoam protection for all corners, three-prong power cord, manual, warranty information, USB that you can use to connect this to a computer or laptop so that it can monitor how this unit's running, and you can also program it to do a few things. Then we have the back side. Starting on the upper right-hand side, we have a USB port, which is what the included cable is for. Below that is a serial port, which serves the same purpose. It's just old legacy. No cables provided for that. It's either one or the other. Then you have, for your Ethernet connection, you can jack into here and jack back out, and it provides surge protection. If you have coaxial internet, there's an in and an out that does the same thing, provides surge protection. Then we have 6 plugs that are surge and battery protected. They are all grounded. This one is for a cube, so it's separate from the others. On this side, these are all surge protected 3-prong outlets, but there's no battery backup to those. So these will receive battery power should you lose grid power, but these will not. But in all cases, these are all protected from surges. The front of the unit has power button, display button, up and down arrows, mute for the alarm, enter and setup. Below that, we have a port that is USB-C, and then we have your standard USB. The plug is three-prong, it's flat, which makes it easier, and it's also offset at an angle. First thing you do is you plug this in and allow the battery to charge, as this will not operate without it being plugged in to charge. So you can't hit the power just quite yet. So we'll let that charge for a couple hours and then see how the unit operates. Once you've allowed the unit to charge for up to 8 hours, you're ready to turn it on. We simply press the power button and hold it for 2 seconds. You hear a beep and it's operational. To turn off the unit, we again hold it for 2 seconds. When the unit's on, the display will come on. You'll see a power plug if it's getting shore power, if it's getting power from the utility. You'll see a little flower telling you that it's going through the AVR, so it's being energy efficient. Basically, it's not drawing from the battery. Then we see our battery level, which is at full, and then there's a load here that shows how much of a load is being put on the system. Then below that is the output. So right now it's outputting 121 volts. And we can change that display. The input voltage is 121. Number of events, under power, over power, power outage, 0. Estimated runtime of the battery is at 190 minutes. There is no load on it at this point. Percentage of battery is at 100%. Output volt amp percent is 0. Output watt percentage is 0. Output voltage amp 0. Watts 0. So that's just straight watts. And then finally, we get to see the hertz of the power that's coming in, the frequency. It's at 60. And then our output voltage is at 121. A thing to know about this display is that it will extinguish after a certain amount of time. Of course, you can override that to have it on or off. There are 3 buttons, but 6 functions. There's an up and down function if you just momentarily hit the buttons. If you long press the button, then you get what's denoted below it. So in this case, if I hold it for 2 seconds, I have the display now locked into the on position, so it will not extinguish. If I hold it again for 2 seconds, now the display is extinguished, but the unit is still operating normally. And if there is a power outage or an event, the display will come on. But maybe you have this in a room where it can be seen and you find a display distracting. That would be a great time to long press this button to turn it off. So for our purposes right now, we'll long press and now the display will stay on. As you saw, this is the up arrow. So if I push it, I can go through all the different modes that the system has. If I long press it, then I mute the alarm. So now, even if there is a power outage, you won't hear the alarm. It'll just always be quiet. Some people prefer that. I like having it in the alarm mode, so that way I do hear the alarm if I'm in another room and I've only lost power to, let's say, 1 circuit. And then I can come in and just hit the mute button and turn it off. So we'll long press, and our mute off option is off. If you want to go into the setup mode, you long press the enter button. And now you can go through each of the settings here and make any changes you want by using the up and down keys and enter to acknowledge that setting. And there's instructions included in the manual, so I won't go through those. Most of these are just best left in the default mode. This UPS is rated for 900 watts, which at 120 volts is about 7.5 amps. So you want to stay well below those thresholds in order to maximize the runtime should you have a power failure, and also to prevent the unit from being overloaded and tripping. Because there is, I'll show you in the back, a circuit breaker should you happen to overload the circuit. By pressing this red button on the back of the unit, it resets the circuit breaker, therefore allowing the unit to operate again. But of course, you want to remove whatever tripped this unit. So if you have five things in there and it tripped out, maybe you want to remove all five, reset it, and then go one by one until you find the culprit that takes you over the limit of the unit. By looking on the device and seeing what the voltage it's using and the number of amps, that'll give you watts if you just multiply the two together. Again, if you only know the wattage and the voltage, then you can calculate the amps. For demonstration purposes, I have plugged into this UPS our tankless water heater. It draws 120 volts at under 2 amps. So we're looking at 240 watts max, which is well within the parameters of this unit. We're looking at an output of 121 volts. And what's our incoming? Our incoming is also 121 volts. So I'm going to run some water so the unit kicks on and we'll see if there's any change in this output voltage. There's no change in the output voltage. Now I'm going to pull the plug on the UPS. So now we have an outage and we see our estimated runtime, 115 minutes. We get an alarm. We see that we are on battery and the load is showing almost no load on this unit. We of course have a full battery. And you'll notice that this number changes as it oscillates with the amount of power drawn by the tankless unit. Because with most devices, that power cycles up and down. It will fluctuate down to a number and it'll sort of settle at that point. But let's say this was running a small refrigerator, the refrigerator cycles on and off. This hot water heater won't constantly be drawing all this power because at some point you'll turn off the water because you don't need hot water running all day long. And so again, this number will change. Right now we kind of see that it's stabilizing at about 107 minutes left. And now we get our power back. And you see we're back on the grid. It's back in energy efficient mode. The output voltage is at 121. And that's how your UPS would work during an outage. We finally get around to talking about the USB ports. I'm sure a question on everyone's mind is, will this supply power while we're on the grid? And the answer is yes, it will. And of course, it will provide power when we're off the grid. So you can use it to charge your devices either way. For those of you who are not backing up your tankless water heater, but instead are using this to protect your PC or laptop, then you'll probably want to utilize the included cable. Big end goes to the back of the UPS. This USB cable here goes to your laptop or PC. You'll download the software from cyberpower.com. Once the CyberPower software has been initiated, it will monitor the UPS, and when there's an outage, this will safely shut down your laptop or PC so you don't lose any data. A few negatives to this UPS. Price. This was close to $180, but for that you're getting a true sine wave device. Also, it's heavy, probably 20 or so pounds. It uses lead acid batteries, which lasts 3 to 5 years. So you're looking to replace the batteries every 3 years or the entire unit, depending on which one's cheaper at the time. But if you're looking to protect your devices, especially electronic devices, which are sensitive to the type of electrical wave, then you want to go with a pure sine wave. And CyberPower comes in at a good price point for a quality product. And I am now up to 3 of these, and I recommend them highly. And again, the downside is the weight, the price, but you're paying for insurance of your equipment. And for me, it's well worth it. If you found this video interesting or useful, give us a thumbs up, leave us a comment, join the subscription team. And as always, thank you ever so much for watching.